Hi, guys. If you're on, let me know if you can hear the music, and if you can, let me know if it's too loud or too quiet. And we will wait a few minutes for everyone else to get on. If you're on, say hey. I'm going to go ahead and type our 5 positive affirmations for today in the comments, so that you guys can repeat them along with me. Is anybody on? Okay, I'm not seeing any comments, so I just pulled the phone up. Hold on. Okay, I just pulled it up on my phone, and I see that there's 40 comments, but I don't see anyone's comment except for my own. So this is going to be interesting. Okay. Oh, no. Okay, so this is going to be interesting today. I can't pull up the video on my phone to see the comments without having the sound on, and I can't see the comments on here. Uh-oh. What can I do about this? Let's see. Okay, troubleshooting. Give me 1 second. Okay, I think I figured it out. I paused myself on my phone, and it looks like the comments are still coming in. So let me know, can you guys see my comment with the 5 affirmations that we're going to review today? Because I see it on my computer, but I don't see it on my phone. So let me know if you guys can see that my comment with those affirmations. Hi, Kevin. Hi, Ryan and Tim and KBC and Nicole and Louisa And Miss Jen. Hi, Miss Jen. Hi, Manny and Audrey and Richie. No, you guys cannot see my comment. Okay. Let me type it really quick then on my phone and let's see. This might take a minute. You know what though? Okay, thank you, Katie. Okay, good. Because I didn't know if I could retype all that. Okay. Oh, Jen, it says it was deleted. I didn't delete anything. Okay. I'll go back later and post them again. Sorry, guys. I don't know what's going on today. And just when I thought I was getting good at this. I guess this is to keep me humble. Thank you, Katie, for copying and pasting that. Okay. Hi, David. I wish I could. All right, we're gonna just roll with it. I'm not, if I have the video pause, I don't get a real time how many people are watching. So we're just going to get started today and go with the flow. So today, instead of doing a fill in the blank statement, I wanna do something a little bit different. It's still sort of a fill in the blank, but what I want you guys to do today is comment with how you have been helping others during this time at home. So that can be helping your parents, your whoever your caregiver is, siblings, roommates, neighbors, helping your pets, whoever it might be. Just let me know how you've been helping others during your time at home. And then after I read our affirmations today, I'll go back and read those comments and let you guys know how I've been helping others. So comment with how you've been helping others during your time at home. Hope everyone had a really good Easter yesterday. I know it was very different than what a typical holiday would be, and hopefully by the next holiday, Mother's Day, and or maybe July 4th, we'll be able to actually hang out with family and have a regular celebration. But hope you guys were able to celebrate in whatever way you could with those you're with, and I hope you still made the best of it. I know here at my house, me and my sister and my boyfriend just played games and watched movies and made the best of it, so it wasn't too bad. No egg hunting or anything like that, unfortunately. So hopefully you guys got to have a fun egg hunt. Okay, one second. Let's see. Okay. So remember, comment with how you've been helping others. That's what we're going to be sharing today. After I'm done reading the affirmations, I'll read out what you guys all said. So I want to hear how you've been helping others during your time at home. And that can be siblings, roommates, parents, grandparents, caregivers, whoever, charities, you know, homeless in your area, whatever it may be. So let me know. Hi, Sahar and Patrick. Hi, Josh. Okay. So we're gonna get started with our positive affirmations. So just a reminder about how this works. You have to say it out loud with me. So I will say the first one once, give you guys some time to repeat, and then I'll say it a second time as well. And they are posted in the comments. So I posted them at the very beginning, so you don't have to scroll all the way up. And then Miss Katie just reposted them as well. So if you need to scroll back and say that along with me, then find that comment. So let's get started. The first one is, this too shall pass, and I can withstand this. This one's kind of special to me because my mom has always, always said, this too shall pass whenever we're facing a tough time. So, this too shall pass, and I can withstand this. And then number two, life is good because I decide to make it that way. Life is good because I decide to make it that way. Number three, this one's kind of a long one, so I'll go slow. I have the strength, resilience, and perseverance to overcome any challenge. I have the strength, resilience, and perseverance to overcome any challenge. No matter how big or small, right? Just tap it on. Thank you, Katie, for reposting those so they're fresh in the feed. Number four, this one I picked specifically because Miss Madison D said on my post last week that she was really struggling with not being able to see friends and family. And I think we're all feeling that way. So number four is, I feel the presence of those who aren't physically here. I feel the presence of those who are not physically here. Hopefully you guys felt that yesterday too, with it being a holiday. Even if you didn't get to see your friends and family and loved ones, hopefully you guys talked on the phone or, you know, FaceTimed, video chatted in some form or fashion. And my hope is that no one felt alone. I hope you guys all felt the presence of those you love that may not have been near you at the time. And the last one, number five, I may not understand the good in this situation, but it is there. I may not understand the good in this situation, but it is there. So those are posted in the comments a few times now, I think. If you want to go back and read them, write them down, put them in your daily affirmations that you repeat to yourself, or share them with others who you think they might be helpful for. And I mentioned last week that it's really important to repeat whatever affirmations you find helpful every day, you know, once, twice, three times a day if possible. But, you know, morning and night when you wake up before you go to bed, really helpful to just keep your mind thinking positively and make them come true, right? So number two is one that I think we can, it's a choice, right? Life is good because I decide to make it that way. So it's all about your frame of mind, your perspective, and your thinking. So if you're thinking negatively, you're gonna feel negatively, and your situation is probably gonna be pretty negative. On the flip side of that, if you're thinking positively, you're feeling better, you're being a bright light for those around you to help lift others up, which is really important, and can then in turn make you feel even better if you've made someone else feel better. So try to repeat whatever positive affirmations or gratitude statements you think are beneficial to you and make you feel good and better. Okay, so now I'm going to scroll back in all these comments because they're not popping up on my computer. If you're just tuning in, I'm having technical difficulties today. Surprise, surprise. And I can't see the comments on my computer, so let me find them on my phone. I asked everyone to comment about one way that they're helping others during this time at home. Whoever it may be in your life, just any way that you're helping, let me know. And let's see what people have said. Elizabeth O has set the table. She's taken out the trash, taken out the recycling, unloaded the dishwasher, and fed the dogs. So it sounds like she's helping her parents, which is great, around the house. And that helps Elizabeth too, right? Practicing daily living skills and being independent, which is awesome. Olivia, I'm sorry you got sick during Easter. I hope you're feeling better. Josh S. has been helping in the kitchen with laundry, cleaning, and walking the dog, which is perfect. Especially walking the dog helps the dog and you, right, Josh? Get some exercise and some fresh air. And hopefully some vitamin D. It's finally sunny. It's been pretty cloudy the past couple of days, but we finally have some good weather today. It's cold, but at least it's sunny. Nicole's been helping feed the dog. Very good, Nicole. Richie helped his niece to find Easter eggs. That's really sweet of you, Richie. Olivia said she's been helping her mom bake, which is good because that helps you too. Katie C. Called her brother on TikTok. That's cool. Thomas A. helped take care of roommates when they are sick. That is really, really nice of you, Thomas. And I bet not only did that make them feel better, but it probably made you feel pretty good too, which is important. Manny's given cupcakes to his neighbors. That's super sweet. I bet they were delicious. Let's see. What else? Louisa has been washing the dishes. Very nice, Louisa. David H. has been helping his mom with cooking, laundry in the backyard. Yard work is really good because, again, you get fresh air, a little bit of exercise. Kevin L. helped with putting dishes away, took the dog outside and fed the dog. Very good, Kevin. I miss you too, Gaul. I miss everyone. Jeffrey said he's been playing games with his parents. That's really good for bonding, passing the time. Let's see what else. Nicole G again helping her mom with the dog. Sorry guys, I'm just trying to read these comments. Olivia P said she helps her niece with her reading, which is awesome. Sarah O, I'm helpful around the house with my family doing chores. Very nice. Chase M helps with the dishes and the vacuuming. I think I remember seeing a post that he loves to vacuum, and I really do too. I have one of those wireless Dysons, so I probably go around and just vacuum the hardwood every day, probably. With two dogs and two cats, it gets pretty messy. Tim works out every day, so that's just helping yourself, but that's fine. That's really important to stay healthy. So nice job, Tim. Vacuuming, dusting the house. Paul said he helps his mom if she needs something, which is awesome. Saida is helping around the house by sorting, folding, and putting away the clothes. So lots of doing laundry for Saida, which is really, really good to be practicing those skills right now. And Nicole's done some laundry too. So it looks like that's about it. So I'm really proud of you guys for helping around the house and practicing your independent living and daily living skills. That's something that's really going to be beneficial if you ever decide, if you're living at home right now with parents or grandparents or aunts or uncles, and then you decide one day to move out on your own or, you know, live in a group home. Those are going to be skills that are going to be super important in order for you to do that successfully, right? So you guys keep up the good work. Next week, I'll have a different topic for you guys to comment about. And again, if there's anything specifically that you're struggling with, comment on this post and I'll try to find some affirmations specifically for that. So feel free to just leave a comment. It doesn't have to be anything too personal if you don't want it to be, but just let me know what you're struggling with right now and I'll try to find some affirmations that can help with that. Remember to say your affirmations every day if you can, as many times a day as you can. And there are some posted in the comments for this week and posted in the comments from last week. And I'll continue to do that each week as well. So hope you guys have a really good week. Be sure to tune back in at 4 p.m. for a daily devotional with Foster. Bye, everybody.